Breaking news on Lubbock TV.
He approached her on the south side of Coleman Residence Hall.
A sexual assault on the Texas Tech campus. Thank God that guy got caught. But 2019 was a year when Tech set a record for sexual assaults. Because of Connie Cleary, universities now have to tell the truth about sex crimes on campus. Her 19-year-old daughter, Jean, was raped and murdered in her college dorm room back in 1986.
Jean's life and our efforts are saving lives and helping others.
Her death is why Texas Tech students were warned about the attacker at Coleman Hall that night.
He's believed to be in his early 20s, about 6 feet tall.
Timely warnings are part of federal law. But why weren't Tech students warned about this?
She says she was attacked as she was walking back inside her dorm and decided she would speak.
In a stretch of just 12 days, we know about four forced rapes that were never reported to students. Chitwood Hall, the Honors Residence Hall, Knapp Hall, and Talkington. Tech tried for months to keep these police reports a secret from you, but they lost that fight. In one case, the victim and suspect were acquaintances, but three other police reports are illegally redacted by Texas Tech to hide what really happened. By law, a quote, detailed description of the offense is clearly public record. But even these illegally redacted police reports showed us something else. Less than half of the documented sexual assaults on the campus in 2019 were even reported to university police. That likely means 16 victims of sexual assault reported their abuse through the Title IX program at Texas Tech. And one of those complaints came from Abigail Easterwood. In August of last year, she went on TikTok out of frustration to expose her alleged attacker publicly. Emails we obtained from Lubbock police show Easterwood was unhappy with the way Title IX handled her complaint.
I can tell you that this client, like a lot of the sexual assault survivors I represent, felt that not enough had been done and she had not been heard.
And it turns out Abigail is not the only female student at Tech who found Title IX help to be a dead end.
You think they have a Title IX problem?
I have not seen the process fairly shake out for the victims I've represented.
It was Abigail's story that made us take a second look at the way the university is hiding certain sexual assault records. Abigail had identified her attacker as a member of the Delta Chi fraternity. So we asked the Texas Tech Center for Campus Life to let us look at emails about sex crimes committed in fraternity houses or by members of fraternities. Tech was right in redacting the names of alleged victims, but we believe they broke the law again by hiding the names of the fraternities implicated in sexual assault complaints. Take this for example. The president of a Texas Tech fraternity reported a sexual assault at the first day of school party in 2019. The name of the frat is redacted, but we find no evidence the university issued any warning to students required under federal law.
I have seen a preference for protecting athletes, students who have more means, professors, individuals who have power. We have seen that repeatedly at universities.
So we know Tech hid news of certain reported sexual assaults from students, from parents, but not all of them. In March of 2020, Tech notified students when a kinesiology professor was accused of fondling a female student in a university lab. The school never reported the outcome of the investigation to students. But that alleged professorial attack will have to be documented in the next annual report by Texas Tech required under the Cleary Act. That will come this fall. But we do have this 2019 report, and that's where Tech breaks the law again.
Act, a federal law that requires universities to submit information on an annual basis to show the crime statistics on their campus.
The university in Lubbock reported 27 sexual assaults under federal law in 2019, up dramatically from 15 reported 2 years earlier.
One report is just as serious as 20 reports. And regardless of what the allegation is or what's being reported, it's very serious, and every one of those is looked into.
Yet Tech fought for months to keep us and you from seeing details of these 27 thorough investigations they claimed they did. What did they produce? Nothing. They did produce 11 sexual assault reports from 2018. But here's the problem. They reported 24. Among those missing reports, the string of forced rapes over those 12 days in early 2019.
And I would like to know the details behind all of those assaults. I think it's certainly interesting.
What else is Texas Tech keeping secret from students and their parents? What other sexual assault victims were ignored? I've said it for a long time. Texas Tech ought to fire all their lawyers because it's clear they don't give a darn about the public right to know. But hiding records about sexual assaults of students, keeping that stuff secret from parents, that crosses the line.